Now I can make my presentation, and today I would like to talk about treatment strategies for early stage lung cancer in Japan. So this graph shows trends in the leading causes of death in Japan. Since 1981, cancer has been the leading cause of death in Japan, and now it accounts for 27.9% of all deaths in Japan. While heart disease accounts for 15% and cerebrovascular disease accounts for 8%. The table shows the cancer statistics in Japan. For mortality, lung cancer stays the first most common cancer in men and the second most common in women. For incidence, lung cancer is the second most common cancer in men and the fourth in women. As for 10-year survival rate, it is 56.3% for all cancer patients. The rate is highest in breast cancer patients, followed by colon, rectum, and stomach. Lung cancer remains at 31%. In Japan, we have lung cancer registry for surgical cases every 5 or 6 years. And the first survey was conducted in 1994, and the latest study was done in 2010. During the past 16 years, the greatest increase was observed in female patients. The frequency of female patients increased from 29% to 38%. We have more older patients. The frequency of patients older than 80 years increased from 3% to 10%. We have more limited resection. The frequency increased from 6% to 22%. We have more small-sized lung cancer, namely 2 centimeters or less in size. The frequency increased from 23% to 39%. Also, we have more adenocarcinoma. The frequency increased from 55% to 69%. And also, survival is improving. Overall survival rate at 5 years is about 51%, but now it is 74%. Results of CT screening for lung cancer was first reported by Dr. Kaneko in 1996. The picture shows Dr. Kaneko more than 20 years ago. Characteristics of screening detected lung cancers are early stage, they are mostly stage 1A, and they are small sized. They are 2 cm or less in size, and sometimes they have grand glass opacity, GGO. I will talk about GGO in the next slide. And they are adenocarcinoma in the periphery. And finally, prognosis is very good after surgery. So, what is grand glass opacity, GGO? The picture shows a typical case of GGO. GGO is a hazy increase in lung attenuation. And as shown in this slide, a bronchovascular structures are visualized clearly. And also, the tumor size is over 3 cm. You cannot find GGO on chest x-ray. So that is why we find so many GGOs on CT scans, but not on chest x-ray. So for surgical procedure for lung cancer study group conducted a phase 3 trial. Results of this study was published in 1995. Patients with T1 and their non-small cell lung cancer patients were randomized either to lobectomy or to limited resection. The paper demonstrated that in the limited resection group, locoregional recurrence rate was tripled and also a 30% increase in overall death rate was observed. So based on results of this study, lobectomy remains the standard surgery. So that is why we perform lobectomy for all cancer patients. I show two cases in this slide. The left picture shows a case of pure ground glass nodule or pure GGN, and the left picture shows a case of solid nodule. They are same, they have same size, and pathology is adenocarcinoma, but they have each different biology, and they have different prognosis. The left case is adenocarcinoma in situ on pathology, and right case is invasive adenocarcinoma. So simple question is lobectomy necessary for all cases? A CT ratio on high resolution CT is important. This case is a part solid nodule. A part solid nodule has two parts in the tumor, namely consolidation in the center of the tumor and ground glass opacity in the periphery. Consolidation or solid component corresponds to invasive foci of cancer cells on pathology, while ground glass opacity, GGO, is the lipidic growth of cancer cells along the alveolar wall. So this is a non-invasive area of cancer. So high resolution CT images correlate to pathological findings, and the ratio of consolidation to tumor is termed as a CT ratio. So CT ratio is predictive of early lung cancer. In this paper, Suzuki examined 69 cases with a CT ratio of smaller than 0.5, and he found in these cases there was no lymphatic invasion and no lymph node metastasis, and vascular invasion was observed only in 3%. So this study demonstrated that a CT ratio is predictive of early lung cancer. Also, for prognostic impact of a CT ratio, another study demonstrated that in cases where a CT ratio less than 0.5, survival after surgery is excellent. The graph shows relapse-free survival rate is almost 100% after surgery. So CT finding of early lung adenocarcinoma, please remember that sunny side up is a sign of early lung adenocarcinoma, like this slide. So in the center, there is the consolidation and GGO in the periphery. So high resolution CT images will be useful in the selection of limited resection for early lung cancer. So prediction of pathological non-invasiveness is important when we consider limited resection. There are four scenarios. The first one is CT finding is non-invasive, then we perform limited resection, and pathology is non-invasive. So this is the best outcome. So if CT finding is invasive, then we perform lobectomy, and pathology is also invasive. That is also a good scenario. Third case, if CT finding is invasive, then we perform lobectomy. And finally, pathological findings is non-invasive. That is also an acceptable scenario because a cure will be achieved after surgery. But in the final scenario, if CT finding is non-invasive, then we perform limited resection and pathological diagnosis is invasive, this would be an unacceptable scenario because we should perform lobectomy for invasive lung cancer. And limited resection in these cases will be under treatment. And under treatment will result in a higher risk of recurrence. So specificity needs to be high to prevent under treatment. So in Japan, Japan Clinical Oncology Group, JCOG, conducted a study, the name of 0201. This study is a multi-institutional prospective study. Pathological non-invasive lung cancer was defined as an adenocarcinoma without lymph node metastasis, no vascular invasion, and no lymphatic invasion. Primary endpoint in this study was the specificity. This table shows result of JCOG-0201. In adenocarcinoma of 3 cm or less, annular CT ratio of 0.5 or smaller, specificity was 96.4%. While in adenocarcinoma of 2 cm or less, annular CT ratio of 0.25 or less, specificity was 98.7%, ranging from 23.2% to 100%. Based on results of JCOG-0201, the study concluded that radiological non-invasive peripheral adenocarcinoma was defined as an adenocarcinoma of 2 cm or less and a CT ratio of 0.25 on CT scan. As for survival of JCOG-0201, in adenocarcinoma of 2 cm or less and a CT ratio of 0.25, overall survival rate at 5 years is 97.1%. Also for relapse-free survival rate, it was 97.1% at 5 years. So survival was very excellent after surgery in these populations. Also, in adenocarcinoma of 3 cm or less, and a CT ratio of 0.5 or less, overall survival rate at 5 years was 96.7%. And also relapse-free survival rate at 5 years was 95.9%. So also in these populations, survival after surgery was excellent. And these cases are possible candidates for subgroval resection. So this is a summary of Japan Clinical Oncology Group JCOG trials. We are conducting 3 clinical trials based on tumor size and a CT ratio on CT scan. If the tumor size is 2 cm or less, and also a CT ratio is 0.25 or less, we perform wedge resection in a single arm phase 3 trial. If the tumor size is 3 cm or less, and a CT ratio is 0.5 or less, we perform a segmentectomy in a single-arm phase 3 trial. And finally, if the tumor size is 2 cm or less, and a CT ratio greater than 0.5, we perform a randomized phase 3 trial comparing segmentectomy and lobectomy. So this is JCOG-0804. This is a non-randomized confirmatory study. Patient with adenocarcinoma of 2 cm or less and a CT ratio of 0.25 or less receive sublobar resection. Primary endpoint in this study is 5-year relapse-free survival. The expected 5-year relapse-free survival rate is 98%. Sample size is 330 patients. Results of JCOG-0804 was published at the ASCO meeting in 2017. We enrolled 333 patients, and 314 patients were analyzed. Wedge resection was performed in 82.2%. 5-year relapse-free survival rate was 99.7%. So survival was very good after surgery, and we had no local relapse. So based on JCOG-0804, we concluded that sublobar resection should be the first choice in this population. That means adenocarcinoma of 2 cm or less and a CT ratio of 0.25 or less. Also, JCOG-0201211. This is a non-randomized confirmatory study. In this study, patient with adenocarcinoma of 3 cm or less and a CT ratio of 0.5 or less receive segmentectomy. Primary endpoint is 5-year relapse-free survival. The expected 5-year relapse-free survival is 94%. Also, sample size is 390 patients. In this study, 396 patients were enrolled, and accrual of patients were finished in 2013. So we are waiting for mature data for survival. Finally, JCOG-0802 is a randomized phase 3 trial to confirm the non-inferiority of segmentectomy. In this study, patients with non-small cell lung cancer of 2 cm or less and a CT ratio greater than 0.5 are randomized into lobectomy or to segmentectomy. Primary endpoint is 5-year overall survival, and the expected 5-year overall survival rate is 90%. Also, inferiority margin is 5%. Expected sample size is 1,100 patients. As for safety data in JCOG-0802 was recently published. In this study, we included 1,106 patients. Lobectomy group had 554 patients, and in segmentectomy, 552 patients were included. In this study, with more than 1,000 patients, there was no mortality. As for complication rates, it was 26.2% in lobectomy group, and it was 27.4% in segmentectomy group. and there was no statistical difference between two groups. So as for primary analysis, overall survival rate will be open in 2020. So next year, we will have our result. So next year, we will have Olympic Games in Tokyo. So enjoy our result with Olympic Games. So there are some special issues in early lung cancer. First is follow-up after limited resection. And second is management of small pure gland glass nodule. And also, I will talk about multifocal lung cancer. So longer follow-up will be necessary after limited resection. In this study, Dr. Yoshida presented surgical outcomes of wedge resection for 50 early adenocarcinomas with gland glass opacity. In this study, there was no recurrence observed within 5 years. So survival was excellent in the first 5 years. However, recurrences were observed after 5 years. Out of 50 cases, there were 4 recurrences, and site of initial recurrences included cut and scar in all 4 cases, and time to recurrence was 7.9 years, 5.5 years, 8 years, and in one case, over 10 years. So limiting follow-up to 5 years is not advisable after limited resection. So we have to follow patients after 5 years, even up to 10 years. So we have more patients after surgery now. So progression of pure gland glass nodule. The left picture shows a small pure GGN in the right lower lobe. It is stable after 5 years, but after 10 years, a solid component appeared in the center and we performed operation. So follow-up of pure GGN, Kakinuma conducted a prospective study with more than 700 patients and more than 1,200 nodules. Mean follow-up period is 4.3 years, and for pure GGN with more than 1,000 cases, growth of 2 millimeter or greater was observed in 14 patients at 5 years, and appearance of solid component was observed in 6% of patients at 5 years. And a mean period until appearance of solid component was 3.8 years. So far, we do not know which GGN grows or which GGN stays is stable. So further study is warranted to establish the optimal follow-up for pure GGN. And finally, I show a multifocal lung cancer patient. She is a 51-year-old female, and she has never smoked. As shown on this CT scan, the biggest tumor is in the left upper lobe. This is a part solid nodule, but this patient has multiple GGN in the left upper lobe or in the left lower lobe or even in the right lungs. There are some part solid nodules or pure GGNs. We performed bilateral segmentectomy, and there was three invasive adenocarcinoma and minimally invasive adenocarcinoma and 2 adenocarcinoma in situ. So multifocal lung cancer is frequent in female patients and in patients who have never smoked. Survival is excellent after surgery. So curative intent treatment should be pursued, but sometimes it is very challenging. We have to repeat operations after surgery. So that is the problem in Japan. So this is the take-home messages. We have more small-sized adenocarcinomas in the periphery. We have more female patients who have never smoked. We have more cases with grand glass opacity, and they are sometimes multifocal. According to the size and the CT ratio, clinical trials have been conducted and results will come soon. Further studies are necessary to establish the optimal follow-up of a small pure grand glass nodule. Thank you for your attention.
Спасибо огромное.
Thank you. But do we have any questions to Yukihira? Andrei Borisovich. Do we have microphone? To device. Это не микрофон.
У него есть английский, да? Можно?
Как ты спрашиваешь? На русском надо? Ready? У меня вопрос.
So my question is, when you perform anatomical segmentectomy, what is the scope? Channel 2.
Segmentectomy. Переводчик. Какой объем лимфодиссекции вы выполняете?
What is the volume of lymphodissection you perform? Is it lobe-specific lymphodissection? Is it sampling or is it a systemic lymphodissection?
I believe your question is... This is Russian, so... We do segmentectomy. Do we perform lymph node dissection or not?
Yeah.
So our indication for segmentectomy is early lung cancer. So there is no possibility of lymph node metastasis. So now we perform segmentectomy, but no lymph node dissection. Only sampling if necessary.
Второй вопрос.
Да-да-да, ну да, пожалуйста.
My second question is, can you tell me, second channel, at which prevalence of lung cancer do you carry out PET? Positron.
Dr. Yoshida, you have to use channel 2, because English is channel 2. You listen channel 1, that's why you do not hear me. So he asked, when do you perform PET? Positron emission analysis, PET. When do you perform PET?
In my clinic.
We do perform PET scan before the operation. And yeah, in Japan now, because it is covered by our medical insurance. And today I do not talk about PET scan, but now we select candidates for limited resection based on CT scan and PET scan.
If all patients.
Yeah.
But if you have patients with PORGGO, do you perform PET scan or not?
If it's very small, we do not perform PET scan, because if it is small, PET is negative in all cases. So we if we consider operation, we do perform PET scan before the operation. But if we just follow patient without surgery, there is not PET scan. So before the operation, we do PET scan.
Okay.
Yeah. So it costs, I think.